Hey, it's Fran. Sort of in the lab space, and you know, I gotta do another video about this because there's a new, totally new chapter in the war against copyright trolls. YouTube has made a change this week that is basically opening up the floodgates for everybody, not just me, to have to deal with copyright trolls because, you know, it started over the weekend. I did a whole Apollo special on the anniversary of the Apollo 11 launch on Sunday, and I did like an assortment of films from my own archive that I've transferred with my own telecine that you've all probably already seen in the Fran's Film Archive section of my channel. But it started this cascade of hits on my channel from claimants on Apollo footage, public domain NASA footage. Now, before people start to comment, I hear the clicketing keys already. Got to put this up front. It is illegal for anyone, anywhere, to claim copyright on any footage that was shot by NASA. Period. No exceptions to that. You can't claim copyright on NASA footage. I claim no copyright. No one can claim copyright. So, things in question here, it's not about music. This is about something new that YouTube is installing called the visual claim. Now, the reason this is going to open up the floodgates is that you might say, oh, Fran, you know, just because you have a film doesn't mean that you own the copyright to that. Well, that might be true for a major Hollywood motion picture. But what about something that everyone has seen, something like the moon landing? Yeah, that got hit by the Canada Media Fund for something they did called Nobel Prize Laureates. What that has to do with the moon landing, I have no idea, but they have put a claim on my video that I put up of the film in my archive for Apollo 16, and all the proceeds from my video of my transfer of my film go to the Canada Media Fund. But even worse than that is the fact that I did a transfer last week of this film. This is probably the rarest and most valuable thing in my archive. It's the original camera footage that was shot of the retrieval of the crew of Apollo 12 aboard the USS Hornet. This is the original end-all be-all reel of Ektachrome. I did a transfer of this and was going to put up a video on the channel. And I showed a preview of that reel on Sunday's Super Apollo Extravaganza, and it got a slam from some completely anonymous company called LDS MISC, and they claim to have a copyright on this film. Now, again, people are saying, Fran, just because you own the film doesn't mean that you own the content of the film. Well, I claim no copyright to it because it is a NASA film, but if anyone could claim a copyright to it, it would be me because I actually own the actual friggin' film. But LDS MISC have put a claim on this because they're a global copyright troll company, and they're claiming that it comes from something called Apollo 12 Uncensored, which my own research showed is a ridiculous direct-to-VHS sort of shockumentary that was put out in 1996 that has interviews with the crew and has some ridiculous third-generation dupe print of my film. So the comments cascade when I talk about this. I put it up on the community page, hundreds of comments. First of all, is everyone saying, Fran, you got to grow a pair and lawyer up. It's time to lawyer up. You got to sue, Fran. You got to take your lawyers. Yeah, lawyer up. Okay, well, the dozens of people that say lawyer up, those are all the people who have never in their life actually employed an attorney to represent them. Sure, lawyer up. Yeah, okay. First of all, who am I attacking? You know, the people in the comments say, Fran, it's time for you to fight. You know, why are you such a pussy? You know, why don't you just fight, grow up here? Okay, well, first of all, Colonel Trucknuts, who am I supposed to be fighting? You know, who am I supposed to go after? You know, this is this is very opaque. When YouTube lists a copyright claim, they don't give you the contact information of the claimant. They don't even tell you really who the claimant is. A lot of times, it just says a third party representing so-and-so, so the actual party with the copyright claim is completely unaware of the attack and wouldn't even respond to you anyway. So it's completely anonymous. And the way that it's set up, the claimant has all of the authority. They are the sole judge and authority. So yes, I dispute all claims, but if you remember, a month ago I lost my copyright battle with Sony Music, because Sony Music claimed the sound of wind blowing on a video that I put up, which was a transfer of a 1973 government film about pollution. I protested it. They held firm and said, we do own that, even though their claim was to a 2003 obscure heavy metal album, and my film was from 1973. I lost because it is the claimant who is jury in this. All I can do is say, oh no, you can't do that because it's not legal, and the claimant can just say, no, 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 double down. And so the floodgates are going to be that with this new visual claim, any piece of footage out there can be claimed by anybody who puts it up on YouTube first. So if you happen to be in a crowd of 100 people shooting a live event of something going on, a speech or something going on in real time, and there might be dozens of people shooting there, the first person to put that on YouTube gets the copyright for it, and everybody else who posts is going to be identified as, oh, you're infringing on the copyright and you're going to have to pay the claimant. So the first person to get it up on YouTube collects the revenue from everybody else who puts up subsequent copies of it, regardless of who actually owns the footage and regardless if anyone can own the footage. And because there are no consequences to making frivolous claims, there's no consequences at all. There's no process to punish copyright trolls. The incentive is just to double down. The incentive for the copyright trolls is to deny all protests of copyright claims because they only stand to collect. All they have to do is say no and collect. And then there's no more recourse. That's it. That's the end of the process. There's nowhere to go to. There's no one at YouTube to complain to. There's no oversight. YouTube has a laissez-faire, hands-off attitude towards this. They don't want to get involved, even though they created it, and even though it's on their platform. And the fact that this new visual claim is going to mean that anyone is going to be vulnerable to copyright claims. It's not about music anymore, it's about visuals. So you do a video of the Washington Monument, and you're going to have to pay somebody who has video of the Washington Monument that they put up on YouTube 15 years ago, and you're going to have no recourse. And I have been playing whack-a-mole ever since Sunday. So the other slew of comments is, Fran, why are you putting it on YouTube? YouTube is dead. YouTube is dead. It's all about Libri and Odyssey and Vimeo and all these other platforms, but, you know, the blockchain things. Why aren't you doing that, Fran? You're stupid to not do that. Well, why am I going to do that? You know, I'm tired of everyone talking up Odyssey and Libri. It's like there's like 30 million users on Libri. That's a big number. But there's 2.6 billion users on YouTube. You can't compare the two. And, you know, the very small, tiny percentage of people who go to a platform like Odyssey to watch more shocking content, there's no place for educational content on these, you know, free-for-all platforms. That's not what they were designed for. That's not what they're intended for. You know, if I was doing videos about explosives, firearms, if I was doing like political stuff that I was just screaming, if I was just cussing people out and just going all at it, well then yeah, that's where I would be. But there's no benefit for me to think that the salvation to this problem, like all the other YouTube problems, is to just abandon ship and get in the tiny little dinghy and kind of row myself out to the deep waters of the sea. That's just not how the game is played. You know, YouTube is the only game in town. It's always going to be the only game in town. And the only reason that platforms like, well, Libri and Odyssey are the same company, as far as I know. But the only reason that these other platforms haven't instituted restrictions on content and haven't started enforcing copyrights and stuff like that, it's just because they're too small. If Libri would ever get to 1 billion users, there would be no way, absolutely no way, that they could withstand the onslaught of the legal system for copyrights, copyright infringement, music, all that stuff. It would be absolutely overwhelming to them. But right now, they're too small to be a threat, you know? And it was the same thing with YouTube. It wasn't until YouTube got to like a billion users that they started picking all the fat off the carcass. You know, YouTube used to be open and free and everything and, you know, all that. But as it got really, really big, the legal pressures got higher and higher, and they had to cave in when they sold to Google, you know. So these other platforms, they're just too small. But mark my word, if they ever get big enough, they will have to succumb just like YouTube did. You know, it's unavoidable if they get big enough. But yeah, there's no point of doing that. And again, I hear people, they're screaming already, oh, Fran, you're so stupid. I mean, here you are complaining about just, you know, you can sync it up. It's automatic. Everything, you just set up the account on Odyssey, and everything you put on YouTube, it just automatically goes on Odyssey. It's like no effort. I mean, you're sitting here complaining and whining like you're just a whiner, and you won't do that. It's like, you know, you're not even serious. Well, you know, in order to do that, you have to give Libri and Odyssey complete authority and control over your Google account. So the way that they do that conveniently is by just automatically controlling your account remotely for you. Yeah, why don't I do that? Why are you doing that? You know, why would anyone do that? You know, I have very strict security protocols, you know, on all my systems and all my accounts. I'm not going to hand over my password and authentication to Libri to do whatever the hell they want. It's like, yeah, sure. You know, you do that now so that it's convenient to like mirror videos and collect blockchain. And then when the change comes, you know, and they get hacked or whatever, and then your Google account gets hijacked or whatever, it's just, no, I'm not going to do that. You go and do that. By all means, do it. I'm not going to do that. I have no interest in being on Odyssey. I have no interest in being on Libri or any of these other like fringe platforms. I'm a YouTuber. I've been a YouTuber like since the beginning. So this is where I make my stand. And you know, I got 240 some thousand subscribers here. Why am I gonna like bust my ass to put some of my videos on another platform where they're gonna get 15 or 20 views? Why am I gonna do that? So, yeah. So yeah, everyone's gonna solve this problem for me, and everyone's going to tell me about how I'm a big whiner, and I'm afraid to fight the big boys, and why don't I just do something about it? Why don't I just lawyer up? Why don't I just sue them? Why don't I just do that? Okay, fine. You know, I'll do that. Just you just wire me the $250,000 as a retainer for me to start the ball rolling, and I will gladly begin my legal onslaught against YouTube. You know, you put up the money, I'll bring in the attorneys. Yep. How's that? So I don't know what this really means for my channel. It's There's no incentive for YouTube to change this or to make it easier. There's no reason for them to shut it down. There's no reason, because everybody in this process just makes money. YouTube makes money because they don't have to deal with the lawyers to have to defend themselves in court against copyright agencies. They just let the trolls come in. It basically, they make money by saving money by not touching it, and no consequence to the trolls, so, you know. So yeah, not really sure what this means. Well, what it means for me is that I'm working a lot more for a lot less money, because every time that I put up some more content that I just want people to be able to see, I'm gonna have to be paying for the privilege of doing that, paying trolls. You know, I do all the work, put it up, host it, and all the money that makes in ad revenue goes to the trolls. And I have no recourse. Because once they double down, that's it. Process is over. Case is closed. There is no such thing as an appeals process. I'm going to go back to work, working for other people. You know, I'm working for free for the trolls now. Working for free for the trolls. You get the content. I do the work. They get the money. That's freedom, baby.
Friend, that's what I'm doing. Working at the bench again.